used to live in Berkeley. Place of banjo is a place of fretless banjo.
How long have you been playing? Good.
Been playing violin for a long time.
Yeah, and then you switched over.
But when I was a kid.
Yeah. But you've loosened up, I mean, where you play good all this time.
I try very hard.
Isn't that strange that the Suzuki system has helped our traditional fiddling in our part of the country?
Really?
Oh, yeah. Any convention, whether it's children or anywhere, whether it's a contest that has a junior division, shoot, if there's 10 of them, usually 10 of them have started out on Suzuki or still are doing it, you know. Save for posterity. If she doesn't want it, we'll give them to anybody that wants them. Then it doesn't make a bit of difference.
That started asking me, who are you and where are you from?
She's a character herself. Instead of playing two, one, two, two, you know, like that, she'd go 1, 2, 1, 2. And finally, one of the old fiddlers, she's dead now. I said, Violet, God, you're shortcutting us all over the place. Play it like the rest of us do, you know. That's before she really got to Silver Dollar City and everything. She was on Regis and Kathy, you know. Yeah. Steamboat, that's kind of like Lady on Steamboat.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah,
like
I got that,
that
slide.
Yeah.
Don't play that crooked thing I've never heard that you played a couple of weeks ago. What was that? All those minors? What was that? That Herman you played. played something that I hadn't heard before, which doesn't mean anything, but they'd play something.
Thank you. because he does the Charlie Cool
right.
number
right.
on it.
Morning.
It's called Robber's Cave.
Robber's Cave?
It's too
much. It's what?
Just a tune from somewhere in southwestern Arkansas.
Steve Green.
I know, Steve. Where are you from?
I live in Kentucky right now. I'm just south of Lexington, Kentucky. You from Missouri?
Missouri, yeah.
So I've encountered you on record before. You can hear
Jim Griffin.
Jim, glad to know you.
Nice to meet you.
You're in
Arizona. Right. Mr. Rabbit, why is your tail so white?
Yes, my lord, I'm getting out of sight. All that stuff.
Yeah. What other couplets did you remember?
The ears mighty thin, they're splitting the wind.
Yeah.
Coat's mighty gray, be that way.
Good.
And your eyes are mighty red. Yes, I'm almost dead. I can't remember what some of the other.
Hey there, Rabbit.
Yes. What did you sing? Yes. Yes.
Yes,
what,
my lord.
I'm a getting there now. Something
like, getting there, Rabbit. Getting there now. Yes, my lord. I'm getting there now. Is the chorus I learned. The only verses I knew was, hey there, rabbits, why is your tail so white? Yes, my lord, I'm getting out of sight. Hey there, rabbit, why is your ear so thin? Yes, my lord, I'm cutting through the wind. Hey there, rabbit, why is your ear so long? Yes, my lord, done put them on wrong.
Yeah, that's...
I like rabbit songs.
Where did you get that up? Some Arizona source or
no? Wade Maynard taught me.
Wade Maynard.
And since then, he taught me two verses,
like,
and since then I found the two verses that he taught me and another verse in one of Eugene Manuel Rhodes' New Mexico novels.
So what model?
Thank you.
Thank you.
that?
So no tape that he's
chirp.
Is that
chirp?
He learned it from a fiddler named Noah Beavers from Elkville, Illinois.
It's on chirps.
Yeah.
Prairie dog.
Yeah. It's actually, it's those are the same. Both parts of that tune are the same. This goes up a fifth in the key.
Is there anything in there?
That's really interesting. It's pretty thing.
Yeah, it's a nice little tune. Noah's really good. Well, you know. Daddy was a Kentucky. He played. Like,
what section of Illinois was he from?
Way down south. He was one of the more really old time. I mean, he used to do a lot of retuning.
That's interesting.
Yeah,
that's something
that's
really going.
Wait, retuning. Yeah, he used to retune to play certain down to these.
Clarence Slangen is a New Brunswick fiddler. Spent his last years in Southern Arizona, so I got
Lani had 14 days in Georgia copyrighted.
Did he have an original Stradivarius too?
No, he didn't have that, but he had this copy. No, that was stolen from a woman in Springfield last year who knew it was really valuable and had kept it under her bed.
Well, no safer place.
I've got four different newspaper stories in the last 5 or 6 years of genuine Strads being stolen in Springfield.
Yeah, that'd be a paper in itself. I mean, that's really,
recurring motif. But she thought she knew who took it. Not that well, I guess she would.
Yeah, he does. Up in Rome, you'd have to see Joe.
That's why he lives so high on the road.
That's true.
You remember way back about 40 years ago in the old Major Hoople cartoons?
Yes.
And you remember that Major Hoople had what somebody decided was an original Strudelberry violin?
Oh, God. Well, there are some archives for research.
The Strudelberry.
Those are rare.
And about the time that it got sold, fed to the hogs or something, the major realized that a strudelberry might be a garbling of Stradivarius. He got all excited.
It might be.
Strudelberry.
Paul, play that.
Art had a woman called him up and said she had one. She said, bring it by. And she brought it by and said, you know, this is really something. I have one just like it. He played it. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Get some water or something.
there a source of beer out in the hall now, or just...
No, well, I just wandered into the reception on the corner.
They run a pipeline?
Yeah, that's nice.
I forgot where it was. What is it? That's not the open. That's the reception.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks for that applause. Their motto.
Cricket on the hearth.
Yeah, that's it. That's it.
And Lachlan Shawplesser, he said Piedmont fiddler.
Yeah.
And he plays in the second part.
Behind the bridge.
Yeah. That's the cricket.
Makes it chirp. It's interesting.
Cute.
Yeah. He's a neat person altogether.
Oh, he's great.
Thank you.
Wound up being walking in the parlor.
That's what I did. Yeah. What did I start off
with? Whiskey Joe.
Sure. The first half, I still think it's more like...
Well, actually, it was dead mongoose. Yep.
Thank you.
old Dubuque.
In the old Dubuque, yeah.
Actually, I was in Des Moines.
Fare thee well,
my pretty little gal, I'm going away in Des Moines.
Among the cattle.
Yeah. You want them more, they'll start to curdle on you. amongst the yearlings. Well, they'd run them ragged, wouldn't they?
Serious difficulty is amongst the young cattle, because we wouldn't think of saying hell in front of you nice folks. That's what Ed Smith of Tucson always called it. Uses that entire line.
Boy, that's a long title, isn't it?
Yes.
Ken Sloan and me now won't. Me in Arkansas, he won't say hell.
Oh,
heck among the yearlings, or he says
trouble among the yearlings.
Yeah. Yeah. Guy in Arkansas, Ken Sloan. In fact, he was Arkansas champion a couple of years ago.
Yeah. And that's
something
too,
I went down to Arkansas this summer with Rosemary, my wife, and we went to Hot Springs and we went to this restaurant, and they served chicken limbs, and that was
well, Taylor McBain always said he didn't say Hooker's Hornpipe. What did he say? He didn't say Hooker's, though. He didn't say. I must have told him it was could be a bad word or something.
Yeah.
Something else. I've forgotten what it was.
Taylor Mac.
Gordon, did you ever hear anybody play a tune called Bucks in the Brush?
Where'd you hear that?
Well, I learned from some people in Iowa who got it from a man who worked at, like a maintenance man at Cornell College, but he was from Missouri, and that was the tune he played. It's a nice tune.
That's a dope.
It's got, but the chords, pretty hard chords in some parts of it. Let's see, yeah.
Called Sweet Prairie Flower. You ever heard that? Dolan, Indiana, in Monroe County, just north of Bloomington.
I never heard Jimmy play that.
You never did?
No.
Yeah, that was, well, you knew him then.
Yeah, I met him a couple years before he died.
Oh, he was a great guy. He had all kinds of good, he was a super person. He had all kinds of wonderful tunes, too.
Yeah.
I got.
Quite a thing.
I don't know if he wants. No, this is total documentation here, man.
I knew it was familiar. God, I hadn't thought of that too.
Jimmy Campbell was just wonderful guy, great. Well, he was kind of modest about his fiddling, but he had some just absolutely wonderful tunes.
Yeah,
he was a great person. From Dolan, Indiana, Monroe County, and Jimmy McCullough recorded him years ago. And you know, I mean, he was kind of.
That's how I learned to do fieldwork, was listening to Judy and Gus Mead's tapes.
Yeah, he was the first guy I ever interviewed. Yeah. And I went to him and he said, well, hell, I've done it before. You know, sure, why not?
Fans pick up Gus
Mead's tapes. Incredible. He's a great guy.
Well, they're usually pretty good.
Best.
The wildlife.
God, I learned some other. Did you ever hear old Bedford?
Yeah, was that that sea tune that he did?
Well, see, he did that white one about White River.
White River Bottom. Is that
White River Bottom.
That's a D tune.
Or is it with D or C?
That's a D. Well, I don't know. Maybe he played it in C, but it's a D tune. That's a pretty standard Central Indiana tune.
Yeah, because I remember. I think I learned that thing from him in C.
He might have played it in C. Yeah.
Looks natural.
Bedford.
This guy, Jimmy Campbell, he called
me. What was that?
Old Bedford.
Okay, that wasn't hard. That's Old Bedford.
It is. It's real. It's similar to something else.
That's what they called it?
Yeah.
You know, no, I always thought it was Bedford, Indiana. Yeah. You know, what else would it have been?
Somebody
I don't think so.
Nah.
Now, they played Soldier's Joy, and they called it King's Head.
Right, yeah.
King's
not,
Head?
Not,
yeah, they sure did.
They did that in West Virginia, too.
Yeah.
Why not? Looks like it's still young.
Well, which one do you want to play, Soldier's Joy or King's Head?
Jimmy can't put that away yet.
But which are in the same or different pressure? Are you in the musical analysis button or the native aesthetic button?
Whoops. I don't know. If you give me a drink, I'll tell you.
No more. My roof was in the sunshine and the rain. Cherokee once a week is a good thing. And his son asked me if I knew why the old man liked Soldier's Joy, and he really did. He'd brighten up. He'd come to more for Soldier's Joy than anything else. And I said no. And he told me the story, and it appears that when the Cherokee survivors of the Civil War came back to Tahlequah in Indian territory after the conflict was over, the band, whatever the band may have been, played Soldier's Joy to welcome.
Huh.
And Soldier's Joy became the honoring song for the Cherokee Civil War veterans, and whenever those old men would get together on any occasion, as long as they were alive, there would always be a fiddler to play them soldiers' jokes. That's just another little bit of history that goes along with that tune.
Thank you.
faster than it. It's too fast.
Played with him for years.
That's Twinkle Twinkle, wasn't it? Dixie.
Oh, no, Dixie Blossoms.
Dixie Blossoms. Supposed to be.
Yeah, it is.
Too
that's
fast.
That's his, well, that was his version of Dixie Blossoms.
It's too fast for any of Art Galbraith.
Oh, yeah. Hunched way over when he played and he'd really go at it.
Hmm?
He hunched over when he played and he'd really go at it.
Really?
Get his foot going like this. Yeah, he was a nice fella. His two sons were enormous. And if anybody was showed up drunk or anything, they just, they could just pick him up three or four at a handful. This one boy's hands were so big, he just, that's all he could do is hardcore type stuff. Well, just this kind of stuff, you know.
Hmm. How long ago did he pass away?
70, wait a minute.
Really?
Manuel Wood died in about 80, somewhere around there. Those are all of them are gone now, just except Art. Art's about the only one left in that bunch that I used to go down and play with. Hmm. Play one more here, Will. Call it maybe. Play something else. Learned off that record.
Well, that's about the only... one.
He needs to make a record every day. Why haven't
he? Bible.
Nobody's going there.
Well, I know they've asked him to. He just, as it says, he's independent as a hog on ice.
Serious. I don't know what the chords are. Dude. Bill, let's wait. Let's see if Paul wants to. Do you have something you want to play?
He's got two. Last call. He's here, Lane.
Well, you're popular, Lane. What is
no,
it?
I'm not.
What is
no,
his name?
Girl with the blue dress on.
No.
Proud of him.
Look at that. I've got the music on there, but
thank you.
Thank you.
meeting.
Yeah, really.
Thank you very much.
Did you guys make up a ballad while you were
there? What was that?
No name. No name, no waltz. Uncle Jim's waltz.
Play one more, Will.
It's cold. Did you do his last call,
Sandy? Getting early.
Where'd you get that girl with the blue dress? Is that a Kentucky
heart? It's sort of my distortion of John Summers stuff.
But I mean, I'm sure it's Kentucky.
Well, yeah, actually, you know, he had some Kentucky connections.
Right.
And it could have easily been that. In fact,
you play the second part just like he does, but the first part.
First part is because I mess up. I can't get the bowing anywhere near what he's doing.
Come on, you guys. Musicians? How about a shot?
Another quarter.
Shot.
Thank you.
Really? That's the longest shot.
Was that ethnic music?
Ethnic, yeah.
That was
ethnic.
Must have been ethnic music. I got beer on my foot.
It's a waste of good beer.
I know. I'm very disappointed about this.
Yeah, I will enjoy.